And if you don't do it, you won't be able to answer that question very professionally, or even better, or even at the point where you would get the salary that you truly want. You need to know how much you are worth to the marketplace. You need to know your value. It's all about value. So here are three things you need to do to answer the salary question. First thing, you need to do your homework. You need to do an online search on the job title and what does the marketplace says you are valued with. What does the marketplace say? How much money does it tells you? The marketplace will tell you how much you're worth. You need to know how much the job is paying and how much you are worth in the marketplace. So you need to go to salary.com, linkedin.com, glassdoor.com, and salaryexpert.com/salarycalculator. You go to those four or five websites, put your information in there, it'll tell you everything you need to know. Never go to a salary negotiation blind without doing your market research first. That's the first thing you need to do. The second thing you need to do is, once you have that information in your hand, don't hold back, baby. Ask for what you want. You have not, because you asked not. So when they ask you, what is your salary requirement, you tell them. Before I became a career coach, I was a hiring authority working for companies like IBM, Ernst & Young, GE, Coca-Cola, just to name a few. I have given over 300 interviews and I've hired over 250 people. And I've always asked the question, what's your salary requirement? So let me tell you what you should and should not do. First thing, once you do your research and know what the job is paying and know what your value is to the marketplace, you give them one number. I know people say, hey, you need to give a range. Later for that nonsense, don't give them no range. See, you think I'm going to be a big man. You say, okay, hey, I want 70, between 70 and 80. I say, okay, what's your salary requirement? You say between 70 and 80. And then when I come back to you and I'm only give you 70, you say, hey, I said 70, 80. You thought I was going to be a big man and give you 75 going to the middle. No. You said 70. No, I said 70, 80. No, you said my salary requirement between 70 and 80. All I heard you ever say was 70. I didn't hear you say between. When you said 70, my ears shut off and I didn't hear no 80. So when you give a range, forget that range. You give one number. Another part you should do is that always ask for more than what you want. So if you want 70, ask for 75. I say, okay, Mr. Clark, what's your salary requirement? My salary requirement is 75,000. Boom. Boom. 75,000 and then negotiate to 70 if need be. Never defer or deflect a salary question. You hear these people out there. Now, I am not a recruiter or a headhunter or HR. Some of these people that work in that industry will say, you know, deflect it. You know, defer it. Forget all that. If they ask you the question, give them the answer right then. That means if a recruiter calls you up and the first interview is 15, 20 minutes, they want to know your salary requirement, give it to them. If the hiring manager calls you up and right out of the gate, they ask you what's your salary requirement, give it to them. Don't be messing around. Never leave your salary question blank in the application. Never do that. And most of these applications now are electronic. They won't even let you leave it blank now. But if they do, never leave it blank and never put the word open. You're not open. You know your value to the marketplace. If you want 75 and the value to the marketplace says 75 and the job says is 75-ish, you don't hire, then you say 75. You put $75,000 in there. You say, well, suppose I say a salary range and it's too high. They'll tell you, hey, our budget for this is only 65. Then it's up to you to go from that point on. But they'll tell you. They just won't kick you out just because you're asking for a higher salary. Don't worry about that. right? So don't worry about that. Never leave a blank in the application. Never put open. Put your actual dollar amount. And so how do you address the question when a recruiter or a hiring manager requests your past salary information? See, I don't like that, right? Because they're trying to lowball you. So what were you making in your last job, they say? Because you were making only 60, 65 in your last job, but this job requires more responsibility. You got to do more, so this job is a $75,000 job, not a 60, 65. So what they want to do is say, okay, I was only making 65, then they give you 60, they give you 68, 69. Or just give you what you were making, because that's what you were making before. So what you should do, my friend, when they throw that curveball at you, hit it out of the park, right? By coming back to them and say, hey, what were you making at your last job? My salary requirement for this position is $75,000. Yeah, I understand that, but what were you making at your last job? You're looking right back into the beady eyeballs and say, hey, my salary requirement is $75,000. I know that. What were you making before? Hey, for this position, my salary requirement is $75,000, because what I was making before has nothing to do with what I'm making here. But if they hold the line and make you answer that question, then you say something like this. In my previous job, my compensation was between 60 and 80. That's stupid, right? Hey, it's not a lie. It is between 60 and 80. You was making 65, 60 and 80, right? That's what I was making, right? I was in that range, right? And I had a great benefit package. If they hold you to it, that's what you give them. But you come back to them, but for this situation, my salary requirement is $75,000. So the third thing you should do, what if they say no to your $75,000 and lowball you at 65, right? What do? You got three options. First option, you could just take it. All right, I'll take it. I do not recommend that. The second option is negotiate. That's when you start your negotiation. First thing you do is counter 10% from their offer price. So if they say, okay, I want 75, I'm only give you 65, negotiate 10%. Now, about $6,000, $7,000. So you negotiate and say, okay, I want 75. You offer 65. Let me counter at 70. Because that's what you truly want at 70, remember? You wanted 70, but you asked for 75, right? And so now they say, okay, 70. If they say, no, I'm a whole 265, then you say, all right, then if salary is out, can we negotiate a signing bonus? Can we negotiate on vacation? Can we negotiate on time off? Can we negotiate on a better benefit packet? That's your second option. First option is to take it. The second option is to do your negotiation. And your third option is to walk away. You need to know your walk away figure. And if it's coming too low, walk away, my friend. There's other jobs. There's other fish in the sea. Do not take a job that's a low salary that you do not want, unless you are unemployed and you need the job. Other than that, walk away. So let me recap. To answer the question on the salary question, first thing you need to do is do your homework. Your second thing you need to do is that once you do have your homework, you know your value and your worth, don't hold back, ask what you want. Because you ask, you have not, because you ask not. And the third thing is that once they say no, then negotiate from there. So if you like this video, like I told you in the beginning,